I don't know if I know the words. Charity benefit in memory of my brother Matthew Varagona. Whether or not you knew Matt, we're all here for a reason. Of course, to have a swell time, but more importantly, to support research for this rare disease, to give Wegener's patients hope to find a cure, or at least delay the effects of this horrible condition. We put this together in like 2 months, which is amazing, and we have to thank a lot of people. A lot of people. That'll be taken care of at the end, though. I'd just like to give a general thank you to all of you for being here, to everyone that put together everything to make this all happen, and hopefully you'll have a great time today. We got some live music. We have Red Afternoon performing from 9 to 11, we're off and on. And then as a finale at 11 o'clock, is a wonderful band. I haven't heard much about them. They're called Explosion on Impact. Two of the Roth boys that went to school with Matt. They're midgets, yeah. And also we have a Daria impersonator. Those of you that are familiar with the Daria program on MTV. So it'll be a great time. Hope you enjoy it, you know. If not, don't blame me.
Buddy and I are overwhelmed by how many people came, and we'd like to thank you all on behalf of Sara and I and Buddy and Jim. I would like to introduce our guest speaker for tonight. She is the chairperson for the St. Louis chapter of Wegener's, and I just met her for the first time tonight. I had the pleasure of talking with her on the telephone. She also has Wegener's, but she's in remission, and she's going to tell you a little bit about Wegener's. So if you can give her her utmost attention.
about this unfortunate illness. First of all, I am a typical Wegener's patient. I also had very typical symptoms. The problem was the doctors don't know about this thing. So in the process of being sick for a year and a half, I almost died twice. I was in the hospital 5 times with 4 surgeries. Let me tell you typically what happens with this illness. If you know someone who has these symptoms, they need to be tested. Okay, starting at the top of your head, it starts with usually an ear infection or a sinus infection. Now that doesn't sound terribly serious, except that what happens is with these infections, you do not respond to antibiotics. Okay, the second area that it attacks after your sinuses or your ears is your kidneys. Most patients are still not diagnosed at this point. The next area that this disease attacks is your lungs. As you know, lungs are not replaceable, so many Wegener patients are on oxygen and have very limited mobility because they can't breathe. Many times it is at this point that Wegener patients do die. Now, what's frustrating is they get misdiagnosed, they do not respond to therapy, and they die. They find this many times in autopsies, a little late at that point to be diagnosed. So what's really important is, first of all, early diagnosis. That's why we ask all of you who are here to take the information with you. First of all of you have a doctor. I know every single one of you have a doctor. Take it to your doctor. The doctors need to know. You know that if you're diagnosed early enough, there's a 90% chance you'll go into remission. And once you're in remission, there's a 50% chance that it's long term. And I'm one of those. But most of them don't get diagnosed early enough. Now, what I've told you is the typical thing. There is one more thing it can do. It's a vasculitis. It goes throughout your system. It attacks those organs. It also can attack your extremities. I know of patients who, because this causes the infections that will not respond to medication, your fingers and your feet can turn black and your fingers can fall off and you can have amputations. And I know of a couple of people who have lost their legs. You have all of these really odd symptoms. Now this is a fairly new disease. This is part of the problem. The Wegener's part, that's the man's name that found it. He's a German, and so if you were German, it's Wegener's. But he was the man that found it. The granulomatosis part tells you what it does. And that means that it's a vasculitis that destroys the blood vessels, which are throughout your system. Now what's interesting about this, as the research goes on, they're discovering that more and more people have this than they thought before. Like I said, so many were misdiagnosed, and the ratio keeps going down. They used to say it was 1 in 1 million, it's down to 1 in 100,000. Now in the St. Louis area, I'm the head of the group, and I have a list of about 70 people that have this illness. And they're all in many different stages of the illness. They all have many different things. There are some things that are very common, and most of them is that they're all just very, very ill. These are the people that you are here tonight to help. First of all, the money will go to research. They need to research not only better ways to treat this thing, but to figure out why in the world we get this thing to begin with, they don't know. There also is the education part. And that's, again, what I said I would like for each of you to do. I want you to take some information to your doctor. If you know somebody who has an infection and it's not clearing up and nobody seems to know what to do, tell them to get the test. There's one test for this. You have to know what it is. It's called an ANCA test. A-N-C-A. You can't run across it with any other kind of test. It has to be specifically asked for. That's what you can do to help. You've got to get the word out. There are more people that have this than they know. We want this to be a good story. So I'm a typical patient at 55. It also hits young people, and that's what happened with Matthew. What's more, when the young people get it, it takes them out fast. We need to get the word out so these doctors know when the people come in to test and to start the right drugs, because remission can happen, and I'm here to prove that. Thank you.
just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Now, some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, a friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.